The 2012 season was one for the record books for Central Arkansas football. The Bears were finally able to claim the Southland Conference title. Now, during the offseason, were y'all confident that this was going to be achievable?
I think I was, because, I mean, I knew the weapons that I had coming back at receiver, and I knew I had a great offensive line in front of me, and I knew I had some athletes at running back. So, I mean, I just knew it was basically I had to fill the biggest part of the offense. I mean, as long as I played and I contributed and I played well enough for us to succeed, I pretty much knew we would succeed. So, I mean, I just relied on my teammates to help me out, and I did my part, so I figured we'd be all right.
And on defense, I mean, we had some great weapons as well. We had a lot of people come back, and we had young guys contribute, and young guys that we seen with a lot of talent, like red shirts, and we didn't have a bad season the year before, so I knew when we come back we was gonna be a team to beat or the team to beat.
Now, you started the season at Ole Miss, and Wynrick, this was your second start as a Bear. What were the emotions like entering the first game?
I mean, it was a mixture of a lot of emotions, man. Mm-hmm. I was calling different. But I actually called Nathan Dick in the hotel before we went.
Really?
I was like, man, how you handle this SEC play? You know, or how different was it? He gave me some encouraging words. It kind of helped me out, you know. And I was just thinking, and I'm laying in my hotel bed like, man, if I'm confident and I go out there and play like I know how, I'll be perfectly fine. So, I mean, that's basically what he was saying, too. He's like, man, just go out there and play confident, you know. Just know what you're doing and do what you know. So I went out there and it actually helped me out because, I mean, playing against the SEC school was actually what we were winning at halftime, wasn't we?
Oh, 2014?
Yeah, we was winning at halftime, so that was a boost of confidence for me. It just didn't carry out to the end of the game, but I mean, I was happy where I played for the most part, but you mm-hmm. know, you could always be better.
I think everybody was nervous going into the game, and by us being nervous, we came out that much harder and that much smarter. You know, preparation was on point.
Ready to play.
Yes, so, you know, we came out that way ready.
Now, in that game, the defense was the storyline for much of the first half. Jestin, what was going on with the defense that day that allowed you to hold Ole Miss to only 14 points in the first half?
We just felt like we could play with them guys. We came out, we banged with those guys, you know, had some success early, so why not roll with it?
You opened Southland Conference play with a home win against defending SLC champs Sam Houston State. The Bearcats led for the first three quarters, but then Wynrick, you led the Bears to two touchdowns in under 2.5 minutes. Did you think that you were going to be able to make a comeback in this game? What was going on in your mind?
First of all, I never give up. I mean, I don't care what's going on.
That's a good mentality.
I mean, that's going on in my mind. I'm sitting there looking at the clock. Because, I mean, you were down like 10 points. I'm like, man, it's nothing. I need the ball. Let's get back on offense. You know, I'm walking, strolling up and down the sideline like, man, y'all better not quit on me. Nobody quit. We go out there, we going out there like we trying to win this game.
Till the last second.
Yeah, we playing to the last second. So, I mean, we know if we get these scores and we get up, the defense is going to help us out and stop them on the other end. So, we got to get it. So, I'm just thinking, like, just let me get back in the game.
Let's do it.
Yeah, let's get some points on the board.
Now, you said the defense, when you were on the sideline with the defense, how confident were you that Wynrick was going to be able to get the job done?
Oh, we've seen it happen plenty of times. We always have battles in practice where they'll get some plays and then we'll get some stops. So, I mean, either vice versa. But as competitors, me and Wynrick, we fight to the last minute.
Right.
I think that's why we get along so well.
Yeah.
So we compete all day. It's practice, meetings, walking down the hallway, you know, walking fast anywhere. We just compete. And I knew in the game, them guys won't give up. Mm-hmm. And he'll talk to the offensive side of the ball. I'll talk to the defense side of the ball. And we keep the heads up, fight to the last minute.
That's my motto to win. Everybody listening, never give up.
Well, the Bears made it to the second round of the FCS playoff for the second consecutive year, but fell short against Georgia Southern 24-16. Has that loss stuck with you during the offseason at all?
Definitely.
That's all we talk about, actually.
Really?
All we talk about is that sour taste we had in our mouth leaving Georgia. You know, like, we left it out on the field, but we could have did some things better. And we just had key plays that let the game slip. So,
I mean, I actually had one of them moments, like, you know, when you have – things that trigger memories, like songs or just something happened that trigger a memory. Well, yeah. Georgia Southern.
The emotion.
Yeah, I mean, Georgia Southern, I know everybody, most people know this song called My Moment. They was playing that the whole time, right? Yeah. So, like, our last drive, and I'm just got that plan in my head. I'm like, okay, I'm just waiting on my moment. I'm about to go out here. We about to win the game. It's about to.
Man, it was like a Cinderella story. Yeah, it was coming back.
Because I just knew. I'm like, okay, this happened to us all the time.
Sam Houston.
It's like, this one of them teams. It's going to win the time that we got to come back. I got this.
Yeah. So what do y'all think happened?
It was just a lack of execution. Mm-hmm. I mean, even all the stops they gave us, I mean, and we kept getting the ball, but we just couldn't execute for some reason. I mean, for everybody watching the game, they know it wasn't one of my best games. Offensive, defensive, it just wasn't one of our best games. Yeah, we couldn't make up for it.
There wasn't one thing.
Yeah. I think we were so good that we could just go out and start slow and end. And, you know, making the transition from conference play to playoff play.
Yeah.
Two different teams, you know.
Right.
Two different caliber teams anyway. Mm-hmm. So we came out slow like we usually do. But at the end, we're playing against a better team that just won't let the game slip as
exactly.
easy.
Exactly.
Yeah, when you're playing against teams that's just as good as you or even better, you gotta play from
really
start
gotta
to finish.
Up.
Yeah, exactly.
You gotta
play
from start to finish.
You can't
slack on just think you're gonna win on pure talent because it's not gonna work like that. And we had to find it out the hard way, unfortunately.
Unfortunately.
For the second time.
Now, Wynrick, the 2013 season will be your second season as starting quarterback for the Bears, but also your first as having a full offseason as the number one quarterback. What has the offseason meant to your ability to grow in the program?
Man, it's been a great aspect of it because for the simple fact that I knew, like, before the season last year, where I was going there before I started last season, I worked so hard. Like, I mean, I just had that in my mind that I know everybody's going to be depending on me, the football team, the coaches, you know, City of Conway or whatnot, because, you know, you got a new quarterback coming in. Nobody knows what to expect. So I just really worked hard over the summer and over the spring.
Definitely wanted to prove yourself.
Yeah, I did so much extra work and it all paid off. I mean, as everyone can see, then watch the game.
For sure,
I
mean, paid off on the field. I saw it.
I mean, it paid off. So
it practicing it against did. Me every day. You know?
Very impressive.
I mean, whatever. But hard work definitely pay off though. So I mean, and going into my senior season, I'm gonna have to work twice as hard that I did last year, and that's gonna be even harder on my body and whatnot. Because I mean, I did put in a lot of work last year, so. I just got to work twice as hard.
That's
so
good
I can,
that you know that, though.
Yeah, yeah. So, I mean, just to compete and then talk bad to him every day. Boy,
no try.
Keep each other on your toes.
He's going to accept the pass or something.
He's not going
to
take it.
Accept the pass? Okay.
He don't throw deep. He don't throw deep in practice.
Right.
Really?
Right. I guess points just come out of nowhere, right?
All from the right.
Now, Jestin, UCA's defense has been ranked at the top of the SLC during your three seasons as starting safety. What areas have you worked on to improve during the offseason?
We just got better at reading offenses, learning preparation as far as studying plays goes and tendencies. We just got better at that. I mean, we always been a physical defense, but we not always been a smarter defense per se. So.
So you know, mentally.
Yeah, we've been growing mentally and bringing the new guys up, you know, getting those guys shaped into the program.
Definitely. Now, the Bears will play against Colorado of the Pac-12 in the second game of the 2013 season. What did you learn from the loss to Ole Miss and that could help the Bears pick up a win over the FBS team?
We're as good as we want to be.
Yeah. I mean, you got to play the whole game.
Yeah.
There
was a lot of games where people had huge upsets, like a couple of years back when Appalachian State beat Michigan. It's like you gotta know you can do it. That's all. I mean, you can't go in a game playing scared, knowing that okay, these guys are bigger than us, they have more depth than us. You can't be thinking about that kind
of
thing.
It's true. At the end of the day, it's who wants it more.
Right. Yeah. So you know? I mean, this is like you always hear, it's not the size of the dog in the fight, the size of fighting the dog.
That's right.
So,
it's still football. So.
And we got a lot of fight.
You're playing the same game.
And this dog has a lot of fight.
Love the confidence.
But yeah, you gotta play with confidence. It's like they're just a normal team, and confidence brings everything. I mean, if
definitely.
You're confident in what you do, you're definitely gonna play fast. You're gonna play hard. So if you prepare the right ways and you're confident, you should have no problem.
Definitely.
Then if you're confident, you got teammates that beginning. Yeah. You know, I can do this.
That feed That's off a good thing. Y'all are leaders, and if y'all go in confident, everybody else is going to feel confident.
Everyone feeds off of that, definitely. Yep.
Definitely. Now, Jestin, why is Wynrick the best quarterback in the Southland Conference?
He practices against me every day. That's an easy question. But, no, like he said, he came into the season with something to prove.
Right.
And, I mean, we came in together, so all I used to tell him before he was quarterback was like, hey.
Better watch out.
You got something to prove.
Dick said that.
Dick has
some. Hey, it was kind of a good answer. Yeah.
Like, I guess.
You got some big shoes to fill, and he just went. He worked hard. He was in film study. You know, he was in the weight room throwing the receivers.
Put in the time.
Extra time. Yeah. And work. So, I mean, it paid off. Yeah. And I always had confidence in him, but, you know.
So he says.
It was time for everybody else to see it, so.
Now let's switch it up a little bit. Wynrick, why is the UCA best defense in the SLC?
Do you see the offense they go against? If I went against that offense, I have the best defense, too.
Where would y'all be without each other? That's what I'm wondering.
But really. I mean, there's just so many athletes over there, man. You got guys from on every level, from defensive line, linebacker, safety position. You got athletes, man, guys that want it and guys that just want to fight for it and guys that want to get better. So, I mean, anytime you got those kind of guys on defense and there's multiple people like that, I mean, it's just an equation for success. So, I mean, if you got those kind of guys that want to work for it and you're going against those guys, they're only going to make each other better. And so, you know, vice versa. So
be unstoppable.
Yeah. So, I mean, making them bat them passes down and chase them receivers after you score a touchdown. That's depressing, you know.
It really
As a safety, you don't want to see those guys score all the time.
All the celebrating together after we pick Wynrick off. And, you know.
Yeah. Now, since the installation of the purple and gray turf, UCA is 11-0 on the stripes.
Don't lose on the stripes.
That's right. You will have 6 games at home this season. So you say the Bears remain undefeated on the stripes?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I'm sure we'll work towards it.
Something about the stripes. What is it?
I don't know.
Purple and gray. I don't know.
Not on the stripes.
Your colors.
I know, right?
And Coach always have his best pep talks at home.
Yeah.
Really?
And always in, we don't lose on the stripes.
Does he say that?
We don't lose on the stripes. So, they don't come table. Yeah,
must protect this.
Yeah, it's definitely going. I mean, I'm going to work towards not losing
any game. Yeah.
So, right, I mean, right, you, yeah. But you definitely only lose the ones at home. Because, I mean, Coach Conk always say you got to win at home and you got to steal a couple on the road. Yeah. If he watches this,
if you want to be good. Y'all win at home, you gotta steal a couple on the road.
Really?
Yeah, Coach Conk, I just quoted you.
Okay, over under 10 wins for UCA.
Ooh, that's a tough one. Because how many games? We got 12 games this season?
Over.
I'm shooting for over.
Over?
I'm shooting for equal or over.
Equal or over?
Equal or over.
Because, I mean, when was the last time UCA had a
10-win streak? We're not losing at home. We've already established that. And we're going to steal a few on the road. So,
and we beat Colorado.
It could be.
I don't want to see that Buffalo.
It could be equal or over. I like the confidence. Over or under 2 playoff wins?
Over. We got to go over. I mean, it's been the last story the past couple of years. There's no choice but to be over.
We know what to do to get to the next level.
Right.
Good. I hope y'all do. I'm rooting for y'all. How much would it mean to UCA fan base to host an FCS playoff game in 2013?
Big one. We felt like we got cheated out of one last year.
Yeah,
but we
definitely should have had one last year. It's crazy. But
this time, we're coming out. We're coming with a vengeance all season.
Good.
Yeah. To have that.
As a fan, I would love it. So,
I mean, they probably have fans like all on Bruce Street.
Right? Oh, it would be crazy.
But that'd be some motivation, though.
Y'all have an awesome fan base. That's the thing.
And it's growing. It's definitely growing.
Right.
I just feel like the whole program as a whole is getting better.
I agree.
Got to give them one more strong year.
All right, guys, we've come to the end, but I have to ask, give us one bold prediction each for UCA football season 2013. What you got?
Well, we're definitely not trying to fall for nothing less than Southland champs again back-to-back.
Right.
And then once we complete that goal, it's on the national champs. I mean, you definitely don't want to fall short. Nothing short of the national champs, so that's the goal. I mean,
that's the number one
not
goal.
Saying it's going to be easy, because no one knows. Everybody knows that it's not going to be an easy road to win a national champ. Not even Southland again, because, I mean, Southland is a tough conference. So
one step at a time.
With the talent and experience we got, I say undefeated national champs.
Love it.
Undefeated national champ.
I definitely think it's possible. Well, thank you guys for joining me today. It's been fun, I have to say. Good luck next season.
It's been great.
Y'all are crazy.